President Trump and others continue to promote the anti-malaria medication hydroxychloroquine as a treatment for COVID-19. Scientists warn it needs more testing before it's proven both safe and effective. Still, as doctors begin prescribing the medication, success stories are rolling in.
We've had some unbelievable results. Unbelievable results. And it also gives the people hope.
Karen Whitsitt, a Democratic lawmaker from Michigan, says her health plummeted after contracting COVID-19. She credits Trump for clearing the way for doctors to prescribe hydroxychloroquine, a treatment she says led to her recovery.
It actually saved my life within a couple of hours, made all the difference in the world.
Pastor Don Wilkerson, co-founder of Teen Challenge, started to feel sick after a trip to his organization's Brooklyn chapter in early March.
I got pneumonia. I couldn't hardly walk or talk. She couldn't understand me very well.
Wilkerson tells CBN News he was rushed to the hospital and tested for the virus. Doctors then just gave him Tylenol for his fever and sent him home to wait for results. By the time Wilkerson learned of his positive test, about a week later, he was critically ill. This time, a doctor prescribed hydroxychloroquine.
The nurse came in at one point and she said, "The doctor wants to give you this experimental drug." And I said, "Yes, I okayed it," and I took it.
While the rest of the day was a blur, Wilkerson says he remembers waking up the next morning significantly better. He says what stood out most was that his sense of taste had returned.
I started to cry and I called my wife, Cindy. I said, "Honey, I can taste. I can taste." Three times I said, "I can taste." I was like a little kid. And I knew at that point the medicine had worked on the virus.
He returned home a few days later. Wilkerson is currently the only person associated with Teen Challenge to have come down with the virus, and the workers at the Brooklyn chapter remain on the job, serving their community.
We have received probably 20 tons of food. 20 tons of food, pallets of food, because we are a distribution center. People have called, they need food, and so our students would tell them what we have. We would pack it in a container and either drive it to them or take it to them.
Meanwhile, hydroxychloroquine still faces several FDA clinical trials as researchers consider potential side effects and health risks of the drug, along with its successes. Still, as Wilkerson and others have found out, doctors have the freedom to immediately prescribe to those with severe cases of COVID-19. Caitlin Burke, CBN News.
Well, so far, it's not a miracle cure. Let me underline that. There are some really remarkable recoveries attributed to chloroquine, and we rejoice over those. But there are some who have received it and did not recover. So realize that the best thing to do is not get this disease. There's another arthritis drug that has had some success. There's some reports out of Israel that are showing they have a treatment that has really remarkable success. All of this needs to go through review. And going forward, we need to look at how can we get rapid testing and then contact tracing if we ever expect to emerge from our shutdowns. It's how do we contain this virus, not how do we treat those infected, but number one, how do we make sure that people don't get infected?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely good prayer points. And at least there are some medicines out there that are helping people.
Yeah.
Better than nothing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's a lot better than nothing.
But at the same time, you don't want this. You don't want any part of it. I've seen the video coming out of Ecuador where it's absolutely horrific. They're leaving bodies in the streets.
Wow.
Because they don't have enough capacity to deal with the dead. In New York City, and right here in the United States, they're having to have refrigeration trucks come to the hospitals in order to stack up the bodies.
Yeah.
And then the other report that you can actually contract the virus by contacting a body that has the disease, that the body itself, as it's decaying, is infectious, which these are all very chilling times. And please protect yourself. Please realize staying at home is the best thing you can do. Yeah. Social isolation is the best thing you can do, and it will really, you know, tamp down the infection rate and hopefully allow us to emerge to a future where there can be a vaccine, there can be a treatment. But number one, we've got to be able to trace. We have to be able to diagnose and then trace all the contacts. That's the way forward.
Yeah, definitely.